and those types of tests to give us a definitive answer to say this is what we know happened.
Do you think that this started off kind of like peaceful and then it got hostile? Because there's one witness who said she drove by, one of the victims is in the middle of the road, and he was directing traffic.
Right.
And she said a few seconds later, she heard an officer screaming, "Put the gun down."
Right. So, again, hopefully, you know, after all the results come back, we can be more specific as to exactly what happened. But it does appear that it started simply as there to help out a stranded motorist. Why somebody chose to shoot and how that all started, you know, we'll have those answers shortly. And again, we don't want to speculate, but it does appear that it started as a very simple trying to help somebody on the side of the road.
And do you know who shot the first?
That's some of those questions our detectives are looking hard into. There are, you know, a lot of interviews still to be had, both witnesses, people involved in the situation. There's most likely going to be video that can be reviewed, so a lot of those answers will come after they've had time to do those interviews, to watch those videos and do a complete investigation.
And you can confirm that officer did fire or shot?
At this point, we're not saying who fired, how many shots were fired, or how many weapons were involved. So we're waiting for those autopsy results to verify and clarify exactly what detectives think happened. But again, it's easy to speculate. It's easy to say, well, obviously this happened. And sometimes when you have the facts in hand from autopsies and other evidence, you can say, well, we thought that, but that's not it. And we don't like to speculate. We don't like to say this is our assumption unless we have a lot of evidence to back that up at the time. So that's why they want to wait and get, as the detectives put, that 100% verification before they make a statement on that.
How long do you expect that to take?
The autopsies are both scheduled for tomorrow, so if those go as planned, which sometimes they can be postponed, but if that goes as planned, should have some answers tomorrow. Toxicology results, which are part of a standard investigation and part of a standard autopsy, may take 3 to 6 weeks typically to get those results back, and that may shed more light on exactly why something happened.
Can you explain who is dead in this case, like which people died?
I don't have the names in front of me at this point, but the subject from Kentucky in the stranded vehicle, he was one of the subjects that died at the scene. The other was what I described in the news release as a good Samaritan that stopped to help a young man from Cordon.
And there were two people in that good Samaritan car. Is that other person unharmed?
Correct. No, he was not harmed. Exactly where he was when this all happened, don't have all those facts in front of me at this point. Would be my understanding he was either still in the pickup truck or had exited the truck. But this is one of those questions that the detectives are looking into. Again, video, those types of things will answer all those questions. But only three were actually involved as far as the shooting situation.
You keep saying video. Is that officer?
There could be a variety of different videos. It's possible that there's going to be officer footage. Households have Ring cameras and those types of things too that record. So detectives are looking for all that information.
What are the officer's injuries?
The officer's injuries described yesterday were just minor scratches, but he was still taken to the hospital just to be checked out and verified. Don't know if there's any correlation with that home there, you know, if why the vehicle stopped where it did. It was next to a residence there on State Road 135. So again, a lot of interviews with people there in the area. What roles they played, if any, will come out once we have all those answers and able to get that.
Why the car was stranded?
At this point, possibly out of fuel, broke down, don't know. Don't know if he stopped on his own accord or if he had a physical problem with the vehicle and stopped. Again, one of those things the detectives are looking into. Detectives are actively have already sought for search warrants, which is typical in a case like this. If you're going to look at a vehicle, anything involved after the fact, they will get search warrants from the court to do a more thorough investigation and look at every aspect of the case.
Do you know why he was in this area?
At this point, I don't have any information as to why he would be especially in the Palmyra area. Again, he was from Owensboro, Kentucky, is our information as far as his driving information. Why he was in Indiana, we don't have that information at this point. Good? Thank you, guys.